Hey, what's up guys, it's your fan Hitesh Kias here, and in this video series I will show you guys how can you run high PC games on low end PC with comfortable FPS without lag and shutters. So in this third episode of this series I am here to show you how can you run Don Bradman Cricket 14 and 17 on your low end PC. So this video is divided into two parts, one for DBC 14 and another for DBC 17. With a single video you can able to configure two games, so it's a win-win situation here. So before starting this video, it's highly recommended that you should check out this video. This video provides you the base for optimization of these two games. So without any further ado, let's get this thing started. So hope you have seen my video that I suggested you to watch. After applying that video, we are now ready to configure the game. So let's start with DBC 14. But keep this thing in mind that if you want to configure DBC 17, so please don't skip DBC 14 part, because these two games are so similar to each other that some settings may apply to games are similar. So we are starting with 14 as it's easier to optimize than DBC 17. So after you are done installing the game, I will ask you to run the game at once. So the configuration file will be created in your documents folder. So let's quickly test the game. As you can see, the lag is massive in the game. It's hardly getting 4 FPS in this default settings. So the game is totally unplayable. I'm running the game on i3 third generation with no graphics card and with 4GB DDR3 RAM. So now it's the time to configure the game. Now open your documents folder and then look up for my games folder like I am doing here. Then find Don Bradman Cricket 14 folder. You can see a config .ini file. Right click on it and hit edit. So this is the setting file where you can update the game right from here. So now pay attention here, listen carefully. This is a screen resolution section. If you have 2 gigabits of RAM or below, then make sure to put 800 in width and 600 in height. If you have 4GB RAM or above that, you can put 1024 in width and 768 in height. Lower RAM computers may lag as there is less memory, so that's why we put lower screen resolution. If you think your PC is too crappy, you can put a lower resolution depending upon your computer. But I think going more lower and lower will definitely make your game like a potato. So now let's go to graphics section. The character is set to 2 by default. Now put 1 if you have a better processor like i3 5th gen or above. If you have a lower processor like I have i3 3rd generation, so I'm going to put here 0. Now put VSync to 0 and anti-anisotropy. As I have a lower processor, so I'm going to put anti-alopecity to 0. Change each and everything like I am doing here. Just leave DOF and Bloom to 2. Put crowd to 2. Then hit save and exit. So now let's test the game. As you can see, the FPS count is improved a bit. The gameplay is smoother. If you feel like your game is still lagging, you can go to settings again and put Bloom and DOF to 0. If you don't want crowd to appear at the back, as you can see here, then put the crowd to 0. This will boost your game performance for sure. Then hit save and try the game again. If you have a potato PC, you can download the config file from the description below the video. Hold up the nerves guys, cause we are not done yet. Now go to game application and hit properties. In properties, open up compatibility tab and tick the box which says run the program in compatibility mode. Then select Windows Vista. Trust me guys, this will give you a better performance. Then after that, you have to go to bottom of the tab and then tick the box which says run this program as an administrator. Now hit apply and click on OK. So we are done with DBC 14 guys. I am saying this again and again. Please go and watch the video that I suggested you to watch if you want to play your game more smoothly. So now it's the time to configure DBC 17. So hope you have seen DBC 14 section, as the configuration file is exactly similar, but there's a twist in it. There is a memory section in it. Before optimizing the game, you had to run the game at once so that the config file will get updated with your video card data into it. I'm really sorry guys, I currently don't have a DBC17 game on my computer, but don't you worry, I got you covered. Now after running the game, open up the documents folder and open my games folder and choose DBC17 folder. Now open up the configuration file. Now put the exactly same values like I have told you in the DBC14 section. If you have a 2GB RAM or below that, make sure to put 800 in width and 600 in height. If you have a 4GB RAM or above, put 1024 in width and 6 and 768 in height. Lower RAM computers may lag as there is less memory, as I told you in the previous section. So now let's go to graphics section again. The character is set to 2 by default. Put 1 if you have a better processor. If you have a lower processor like I have, then put 0. Now put VSync to 0 and put anisotropy to 0. So once again, I'm going to ask you to copy these settings that I'm doing. Now, if you want to see the crowd, you can put crowd to 2. If you want a game without crowd, then put 0 there. So just like previous settings we have done in DBC14, do exactly similar for DBC17. Go to properties again and do those compatibility and check the box to run the game as an administrator. So this is all for this video. If you have any problem related to this video, make sure to leave a comment down below in the comment section. Oh god, I forgot to announce the winner of the giveaway on my previous episode in this video series. The winner is a Russian hacker. Guys, if you want to win the giveaway like he have won, make sure to leave a comment down below. I'll be picking a winner from the comment section, so comment hard and I'll announce the winner in the next episode of the series. This time the prize is a random Steam key, and for my Indian viewers, I'm going to publish this same video in Hindi after some days. So this is all for this video. Make sure to subscribe to our channel if you want to see more videos like this one. So I'll see you all in my next video, and if you like gaming, you can check out my channel, which is full of Hindi commentary gameplays. And after this video, I'm going to start DBC14 gameplay on the channel in Hindi language. So don't miss the action, subscribe now, and I will see you guys in the next video. So till then, stay safe, peace over and out.